Junior will come and will read our scripture coming from Genesis 28th chapter, verses 10 to the end. Genesis 28, verses 10 to the end. And as he's making ready to come to God, be the Lord.
Always, Lord, we need you. We can't
work without you, but with you all things are possible. Therefore, we ask you to open our eyes that we may see Jesus, trying to work in our life. Open up, Lord, not only our eyes but our ears, that we may hear a word from you. And then, oh God, open up our hearts, that your word may be safely lodged in the repository thereof. That no matter where we are, your word will rise up and help us to meet every occasion. This, oh God, is our humble prayer, and it is in Jesus' name that we do pray. And as God's children, we say amen. May be seated in the presence of an almighty God. Are you climbing the right ladder? I mean, several folks that have just continuously lift me up in prayer because none of these notes are coming together. It's just got to come up and come out. So when you do that, you got to have some folks praying for you. Amen? Because it's a serious subject. Because of the simple fact that there are many folk that are out in the world now that are trying to do everything in their power to manipulate situations to do it their way. You got folks that have an agenda, and their agenda is to force what they want to make you do it even in the church. They're afraid to go by the ballot box because they don't believe that they will win there. They're afraid to go to the House and the Senate because they don't believe that they'll really get a good showing there. Some folks will show up and act like they're in your corner, but they're really not when it comes down to the vote. Amen, somebody. And even though you may get some support here and there, a lot of folks will try to just make you do what they want you to do. So if they can't get it through the ballot box, if they can't get it through the Senate and the House, what they, and if they get a little bit from the White House here and there, what they really try to do is go through the court system and make you say that it's all right to do what I want done. I wish I had somebody praying with me. But what we have to understand is, my brothers and sisters, as Danny taught me as a little boy, there's no right way to do something wrong. You can try to qualify, you can try to fix it up, you can try to make it what you want it to be, but there's no way to do something wrong. And you can try trickery, you can try all kinds of things to make things go in your favor, but if you don't do things the way the Lord wants you to do, you'll end up with more misery and heartache than it's worth. Yes. Have I got a witness in this room? Yes. Consider Jacob. He wanted to get things his way. He wanted to get his father's blessing. His father was going to give the blessing to the oldest son, Esau, which was the direction that he needed to go. However, through trickery, Jacob came in and dressed up like his brother and even had the smell of the field on him. And by this time, his father Isaac, his eyes were dim, which means he couldn't see that well, but he smelled him and he felt him and he thought it was his son Esau. And he turned around and gave him the blessing. He even turned around and he stole his birthright from his brother after he had been out there hunting, and he was tired and he was thirsty and he was hungry, and he made himself a birthright for a bowl of partridge. Got to the place that Jacob had just got sick and tired. Esau had just got sick and tired of his brother's trickery.
Yeah.
And he made up his mind that after his father died, I'm not going to cause no trouble right now, but after Daddy died, after the funeral, I'm going to kill you.
Yeah.
All the trickery don't feel no good at all after somebody's out to kill you because you know you're wrong.
Yeah.
And so he finds himself now on the road. You know, you can run away from trouble, but it gets to the place that trouble has a way of finding you when you're doing wrong. As I mentioned before, there's no right way to do wrong. You can find your special group that says it's all right to do wrong, because that's, after all, what Jacob did. Jacob went to his mama, and mama helped him set up to be mad somebody. If your mama ain't helping you to do right, she's just as wrong as you are.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody.
Yeah.
And so here we find Jacob on the road. Done turned to everybody and everything, really, but God. And sometimes when you've been running so long, God will get your attention one last good time and bring you down to your knees. Notice what Jacob did. He was out in the middle of a desert. And he was so tired till he took a rock and he made a pillar out of the rock. You know, those folks used to say it like that, you can make your bed hard. You see, somebody in here is trying to build their way to God. Amen, somebody.
You're a child of God. To be absent from God is to be present with the Lord. You don't have to worry about the second death, which is separation from God for eternity. It's not because of your righteousness. It's not because of your way. It's not because of how good you are or not. It's because of the blood of Jesus Christ. And if nothing else can wash away your sins, you got to make sure you hook up to the right ladder. The one that comes down from above to you. And you can't go up no other way. The Bible says if you try to go in another way, you're looked upon as a thief. Amen.
Amen.
So you've got to come the way he wants you to come. I couldn't write that thing the way I wanted to write it, but I had to tell it the way you gave it. I want to make sure that you got the right now in your view. Don't go to hell from the church. And don't buy this ticket of saying, well, you know, I'm going to get myself together. And then I'm going to come to church, but I want to be no hypocrite. So you're going to die and go to hell if that's your philosophy. Why? Because you can't fix you. But Jesus can fix all of us. He knows just what to do. That's why Jacob prayed. He said, Lord, if you just go ahead and keep me, if you just go ahead and take care of me, you give me back to my father's house, so I'll go ahead and serve you, plus I'll give the tithe, which is a part of worship. I'll give you. I'll make sure that I'm supporting what's important to you. I'll do it as a part of worship, not as a part of I gotta do it, they beat me up about doing it. No, I'm doing it because I'm thankful that you came down to seek about me. Emmanuel, God with us. Let us stand to our feet. If you still trying to get this thing done your way, if you still trying to say, well, I'll be good enough to get to heaven because I'm not good, I'll wear my bag, that's Muslim theology. That's not Christology. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
That's what they believe. They believe if their good outweighs their bad, then they'll get into heaven. But the Bible says that there is no other name given unto man whereby we must be saved. There is no other way to be saved. Not your good outweigh your bad. It's got to be the blood of Jesus. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. If you have not accepted Jesus Christ, and what does that mean? It's not abracadabra, hocus pocus. It's not a sense of, well, I just say the words and then that I got it, I'm in. No. You have to believe in your heart that Jesus died for your sins. You have to believe you're a sinner. I'm a sinner. And I can't save myself. I have to accept what Jesus did. He died on the cross, and he had all the sins of the world upon his shoulders when he died. And that's the only one that can save us. And so I accepted his death. I should have been the one on the cross. You should have been the one. But he went for us. And even, as I heard one theologian say, he's a lunatic, he's crazy. He's out of his mind, or hell must really be real. And I believe hell is real. And I believe heaven is real. And I believe that the songwriter said, I don't know why Jesus loved me. I don't know why he even cares. I don't know why he sacrificed his life. Oh, but I'm glad. So glad he did. If there's someone here under the sound of my voice that wants to be saved today, I need you to come and accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. believe that he died for your sins. God raised him from the dead. He lives now and forevermore. Is there one? Is there one? Is there one?
Behold.
You're going to have to fall out. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming because I've asked to be a long-time billionaire so that I'll be able to be a blessing to the body of Christ. I'm looking forward to God doing great things within the body of Christ. And it's not about money. Money is just a tool to me. Amen. To be used by your hand to do what needs to be done. But you gotta prepare yourself. You gotta be ready so that when it comes, you won't be a church that'll be saying, well, why don't he get my friend? Why don't he get so-and-so? We live here. I gotta get whoever's qualified to go where we're going and to get us where we need to go. And this building project that we're in is kind of like it is. Nobody in here can go out and be the contractor. Amen? Nobody in here can go out and be the architect. The drawings that they want, you couldn't have done that. I couldn't have done that. We're going to have qualified folk to go where we're going. So when you see it coming, it may seem slack time now, but be in prayer, be in preparation. This is a time of preparation. Be ready to go do what God wants you to do. Because when it's God coming, it's going to come fast. And some are going to be saying, wait a minute, slow down. No, we got to go. We've been waiting on this. The prayers of those who prayed at Southern Baptist under a tree in 1876. Those prayers didn't die. They're coming. They prayed that we would have a building. We have one. They prayed that we would be able to have worship like this. We're having it. God has brought us from a mighty long way. We got a long way to go. And he's able. He's able. It won't be about me. I'm just watching him. Father, we come to you right now in the most meek and humblest way that we know. We come with our head bowed. We come with our eyes closed. Some of us come on our bended knees. And some of us, Lord, come and just stand around this altar. And Father, we want to tell you thank you. Thank you, Lord, for making a way from heaven to earth so that we would have a way from earth to heaven. God, we thank you for that. And we take the time, Lord, to pray right now, Lord, and give you thanks for blessing Jared one more time to be able to make it through another car crash. Father, we don't know what you got in store for this young man, but Lord, bless him, Lord, as you have been blessing him left and right and up and down and back and forth. Lord, as we look at this, first it was a side swipe. Then, Lord, it was a rear end collision. And then, Lord, a front head on collision. Yet you kept it. We want you to know that we don't take it lightly, Lord. We thank you for sparing and saving his life. Then, Father, we pray, Lord, now that you have set us up to be able to see that you're able to keep us from all hurt, harm, and danger. We pray, Lord, for each one that has come to this altar. Some come for one thing, and some come for another. Lord, we pray for help, for strength, for healing, for ableness about the body right now, in the name of Jesus. Father, we come and we pray right now, Lord, that you would just bless those that are now struck, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you'll build them up on every torn side. We pray right now for marriages, Lord, that you will bring husbands and wives closer together, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you will just bless in a mighty, mighty way. Father, we pray, Lord, that you'll remember each one that is singing, Lord. Bless them to sing to the glory of God. Bless each one that is dancing, Lord, to dance for your glory. Bless the musicians, Lord, to continue to play and lift you up in song and in music. Heavenly Father, help us to be the kind of church that when folks come, Lord, they'll feel your presence. My house will be a house of prayer. Pray that they have strength and ableness about the body. Pray that they're blessed going in and blessed coming out. Pray for them. Pray for your neighbor. Pray for your friends. Pray for your church members. God is able to do just what he said he would do. Pray for him. Now let somebody pray for you. Pray for the partner, the one that's praying for you. You pray for them now. Just lift them up in your own words. Don't try to fix it up. Just a little talk with Jesus can make everything all right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now God's been good through you, to you through this service. Give him a hand clap of praise as you return to the scene.
Yeah.